Welcome, everybody. You are enjoying the day. It's a chilly day here in Maine, 40 degrees Fahrenheit. And my name is Sasha Derry. I'm the CEO and founder of bluShift Aerospace. This is Rev B of our MAREVL engine. We are in the thirds, I think, in terms of engine tests. The MAREVL engine you see on the screen here today is our full-size MAREVL engine. It's what's going to ride and is what's going to take our suborbital rocket, Starless Rogue, all the way to space, a single engine. And seven of these is what's going to carry our orbital rocket, Red Dwarf, all the way to space, and carrying up to 100 kilograms of small satellite payloads into polar and sun-synchronous orbit. So we're very excited about today's test, and I'll tell you why. The reason this is so different than the test pass is, well, it's completely different. What you hear is an engine that under the hood, everything's been changed since the last test in December of last year. So it's been, I can't believe it, but it's actually been 6 months since our last test. And the last test was, I think, a little over 20 seconds. It was our longest burn ever. This test will be shorter, in part because it's all new components and a complete change out. But what we're really excited about for today's test is to see how the performance ekes out. The engineering team has made an incredible amount of changes and tweaks and upgrades to our oxidizer flow system, the fuel grain, proprietary fuel in there, even the nozzle. And we are expecting increase of power output and thrust between 30 and 50%. So if things go okay, what you'll see is the engine will ignite. It'll take about a second or so to ramp up. And then the burn will last, my understanding is it will last just over 10 seconds. And we'll have a shutdown. And if this goes well today, we will be moving to full-size oxidizer containment. That oxidizer containment system will be what is all the way to space. That'll be provide us with the ability to provide a 60-second burn. Getting feedback from the team, and it looks like we are good. We are good for a go on the test, so it's going to be a few minutes away. And what you're seeing here is the MAREVL engine. Engine's now longer than the previous version you saw back in December, and I'm expecting a much tighter burn than I saw in the past. In the test, we saw a really fuel-rich burn, which the flame looked to me a little bit late. It's hard to explain, but if things go well, we'll see a very good oxidizer to fuel ratio and a much tighter burn. This test could go multiple different ways. You could have the ignition. That might be one way. Things could pop. If it pops, we have a very heavily engineered and designed system to handle any sort of any poppings of our engine. And then, of course, the test could shut down prematurely, as we've had happen in the past. But if it goes really well, what we'll see is a really tight flame. And in my expectation is that flame will not hit the wall. It might push that deflection wall, but it won't touch it. If it does touch it, my expectation is that will be a fuel-rich flame. So what we're looking at is something between a 16,000 pound thrust from the engine test today, if all goes well. And hold on just a second. I'm hearing from the engineering team. Thank you. All right. So I apologize for the buffering. We are having some data upload issues here. We're working to help reduce those issues. So my apologies. And I just want to point out to folks that that are hearing us well, we will definitely be doing a high resolution videos for everybody in the next day. And so you'll see a really good coverage of the test from all angles, including potentially another VR, another 360 VR video feed that you can watch with an Oculus Quest. So stay tuned. I think things are going very well, and we're about 2 minutes away from test here. I'm going to tune in a bit to the engineers. Again, our apologies for the quality of the data feed. We're a bit bandwidth starved. We've been able to address it slightly, so hopefully this is coming through a little better. And again, if the video breaks up or it gets choppy, blocky, in the next day or two, you will see a high resolution version of all these videos that we'll share with everybody out there on YouTube. Thank you. About to test the valve, the fire suppression system, so stand by. Fire suppression test should be started momentarily. Okay, so the team is going through a couple exercises, make sure all the safety systems are up and running correctly. Looks like we're all good from what I'm hearing. We're located, Lindsay and I are located in the RV across the runway about under a mile away, and our team is largely, some are deployed close to the test stand for safety shutdown operations if we can't do it remotely, and then we have the rest of the team in the hangar at our location here at Brunswick Landing in Brunswick, Maine, the former Brunswick Naval Air Station. And so that is the hangar, our mission control center, where our offices and manufacturing workshop is located. So things are looking good right now, and we'll get the 1 minute warning here very shortly. Apologize. I see that we are still getting some buffering on the live feed. We apologize. Dealing with the bandwidth we're given here today. Okay, so I just got the word from the engineering team that it's about a 5 minute hold delay, and everything's looking good. I just want to really make sure everything is checked off and all the readings are where exactly dialed in where we want to be. So I'm going to expect about 5 minutes up from now is when we'll be attempting the next burn. Okay, ignition sequence has begun. All right, we're looking, and then now is, yep, looks like we're having some issues with ignition. Standby. Okay, we hear the siren. And we're going to make another attempt for the ignition. Okay, so what you saw there is another attempt. Like I said, this test can go many different ways. And what you saw right there was, or what you saw and heard, was the attempt for the igniter to go on. We have a reusable igniter, and it did not initiate. So the team is working on what could be done to make a reattempt. Stand by. Okay, so the team is working on, there may be some vapor in the system that has to be expunged, and they're looking to do that shortly. And see if this works, and then they're going to make another reattempt at ignition. All right, the team is thinks that we might have iced up the igniter, and we're trying to do so how to overcome this issue. But I'm saying it's probably looking unlikely the test will happen today. But the team is looking at some options on the table, and I expect we'll know within 5 minutes if this is a go no go for today's test. All right, good news. We're gonna try again. So the team's gonna try. It does sound like when we're hearing that the system might be iced up, but we are gonna give it another shot here. So stand by. I think we just had some good news there. I heard it. If you're listening to the, you could hear a little poof. And that was the sound of igniter going. It was, if it was indeed iced up, it was like it's getting de-iced. So what the guys are doing seems to have an effect. I think, and we're going to give a few moments. So this is looking more likely to happen than I thought today. And bye. All right, the team's gonna try the sequence again. Stand by. Yeah, so looks like again it did not ignite. You could hear the clicking of the valves, and you didn't hear the pop or the poof or the vroom. So I think we're being challenged by the humidity in the system and the coldness of our oxidizers that flows out and maybe icing things up. Another reason to hope for a warm summer day in Maine. The team's thinking of some really creative ideas in here and how to liberate the system. All righty, we're trying to. Here we go, I hear a poof. Poof. Okay, we're looking good. Looking good. Oh, I heard the igniter going there. Some ignition. It's not quite what we need, but we are getting a temperature change in the combustion chamber, but it's not what we need. We're still working at it. But this is progress. have Luke, our senior mechanical engineer, quoting this. I'm quoting him as saying this is like one of those corded lawnmowers where you have to pull to get it started. We're seeing temperature changes in the combustion chamber, but it's the flame front's not holding.
Thank you.
Roger. All right. Another attempt here. Let's see what happens. Test that igniter so we can hear the valves turn it off and on. Ooh, that's the right sound right there. I hear it kind of struggles. That's the right sound. Sounds like a jet engine trying to fire itself up. You can just hear that one of the valves is just like, right sound. Oh man, that is maneuver rolls to that burn go where it is. So I'm guessing he's playing with the fuel in the oxidizer and the igniter. We have a liquid igniter to get it up and running, and it is struggling. So he's almost got it working. It's just funny to hear it squealing. It's terrible. Thank you. All right, if nothing else, we have an igniter. It's getting a lot of exercise. And the team is coming up with actually an alternative solution here for ignition. They're kind of game playing on whether this is the right thing to do, if I might foul the whole engine for any attempt. New records on the temperature inside the combustion engine, but not the right one to get this candle lit. So we're hearing folks volunteering to throw a lit log inside there. We can't do that, unfortunately, but it is how the Russians do it. It's not how we do it, though. It is tempting, and it's similar to the way I used to light the engines back in the day. It might be asthma. Team does have one fallback card to play with this engine. Yeah, the igniter is starved from oxidizers we're having a problem with, and it's hard to know what happened to that valve and to take it apart, but I think the team is going to try one backup run at liberating some oxidizer here, and that might get the lit. Stand by. a lot of people here locally watching on off the road, and some VIPs. Everybody's frigid outside in this cold, cold, wet weather, waiting to see this engine light. So big thanks to everybody who's tuning in, but also big thanks to everybody who's outside freezing their buns off right now to see if we can get this lit. Ignition has always been challenging with this type of engine, and we do use igniter. It is reusable. Is a decision we've made that we want to have the capability of reigniting. Obviously, we're having a problem just igniting right now. This is not it's not uncommon with this type of engine, but it's also not uncommon that we completely overhaul the engine to really improve its performance. So it's not super surprising that we're at this issue. We have this problem at this time, but the game's not over. They're gonna try again. Ooh. You can hear it. It wants to start. It wants to turn over. The guys have still not pulled the ace out of their pocket. They're holding back on that last play that we had. Holding off. That's the right sound. Just has to last longer. All right, the team's gonna try just three more minutes of this pattern of trying to get the igniter to work the normal way. And then we're gonna go to the ace in the back of our pockets to see if that will work. Maybe it's not an ace, maybe it's, I don't know, my cards will go for a queen or a jack. But there's a good chance that the card they're gonna pull will just kind of freeze up the whole system entirely. I'm gonna pay attention to the feed here and questions people have. Yeah, Aero Parama says, it sounds like it wants to go, and it does want to go. Stand by. Ooh. Thank you. UV pulse with modulator or oxidizer and an injector. And depending on what the team's doing here, not maintaining open state. Thank you guys all for the patience. Your patience, really appreciate it. Teams, you can hear that sequencing because the oxidizer is buffering. And turning off and on to allow some flow, but it's not allowing for enough flow. So it could be a check valve in the system, could be a filter in the system, could be the valve. And again, they're holding off for... That's just the right sound. Holding off in that final... Okay, the team's working through that option, the back pocket option here. Thank you. talking through some scenarios. You're going to see something out of this. Might be a puff. But they are going to be trying something novel. Novel for us. And we won't be using any interns to light this engine. We think that the we need to let the system. We need to let the system kind of get to ambient conditions a little bit. Just kind of hold for a little bit and let the system kind of get back to us or closer to the environmental conditions outside, and then retemp. The team just got really close with here a second ago. And that happened only after they held off from clicking the valves. So stand by. Thank you. Yeah, so we're definitely turning it back on and off. Alright, so the team is a minute here to kind of get the ambient conditions. I'm going to try again. This is a. And the conditions being manually. And. and the team is asking if I will go out there with a sparkler to light it. I would, it's just a long haul. Just doesn't want to burn long enough. Alright, the team's still off on the ace in the back pocket here. And you can tell that igniter is stubbornly not wanting to go. I think it's getting choked on flow from the oxidizer. Still, just doesn't want to go. Believe me, we wanted to go. one more different sequence. Oh, this poor engine that could. I guess somebody else said that in the chat room too. We're channeling the same thoughts here. I'm just really thankful we're not trying to reignite this engine in this format while we're descending to planet. It'll be a lot more sketchy for landing for us. The team is feeling pretty optimistic that there's a solution here. Really thank you guys all for holding tight, being patient. We did not mean for this engine test to be nail-biting, but it is for all of us. So thank you guys for patiently holding in there. And our CTO says this is the longest ignition in the history of rockets, we think. I'm going to guess perhaps not. It's probably others have tried. Sorry. And I hit the siren just to kind of clear the zone, just in case there's anybody that possibly could have entered the safety zone that we can't see. They're getting real close. Oh. This is looking better, guys. Looking much better. Getting toasty in there. Begin to burn through our reserves on the ignition fluid, but they're still trying. We still haven't pulled that ace out of our back pocket. The ace may not be a sure thing for the last shot solution. Yeah, so continue to have oxidizer issues on igniter. Pressure on the igniter fluid is going down, but it's not over yet. It's not over yet. It's not too low yet. And we haven't pulled out the last final card yet. And yeah, we're gonna do our best to beat the Ariane 6 to light this sucker. So stay hopeful, guys. Stay hopeful. One of the tougher things about lighting engines is how dangerous they are. And boy, if you get closer, it would make life better. But you just can't with this size. Too much power. Too much danger. All right, they're gonna let it sit for 5 minutes and see how the back to restless state and reattempt here. And then I think we're going to try that. Pull that back. My final ace. Alright, they're gonna wait till 6:30 local time and try again. 6:35, thank you, sorry. I'm gonna wait till 6:35, try again. I'm gonna hold the system. Thank you guys for your patience. I know this has been hard. This has been a long wait. And I'm gonna go outside and thank the people who've been freezing their buns off outside. Okay, so once again, if you're tuning in, it's 6:30 local time. Okay, 6:35 is when we'll try again. There seems to be something positive happening. We let the system sit for a little bit, and they want to try it again. And then I think we really are going to try that final shot, which will either work or it will cause us to have to shut down the test for today. Thank you. All right, so I'm going to answer some of the questions I see on the YouTube channel here. So let's see, Batsayana asks, could you describe the composition and ignition source for us? So yeah, the solid is a proprietary fuel, solid fuel. The substances are derived from farms, you know, all over the country and all over the world. The ignition system is basically a torch. It's a liquid fuel and liquid oxidizer torch. The team was able to get to work successfully outside of this test many times. And of course, when we put the engine all together, things change. And we think, well, we're not sure. We think it could be a valve, it could be a check valve, it could be a filter in the system that's choking the flow of the oxidizer. And the team is working through a couple different options. So we've got about 3 minutes here, and the team's going to reattempt. See if I can catch up with some of the other questions people have. Just want to kind of reaffirm. Metric Black says, it's this crappy weather, you know? That's true. That's where every time we have ignition issues, was this engine or engines before, it is when it's really cold and moist. Things lock up and get frozen. Fractured gamers onto something. Let the flooding subside. Yeah, instead of flooding, it's what's going on is the liquid fuel, which is it's basically ethanol, is what we use to start the system. Also bio-derived, not our main fuel. And there's not enough oxygen in that fuel right now. So the fuel flow is good. It's still good, even though it's running low. It's still good. But the oxygen is what is choking the system. It's just not enough flowing through. And so we might try ever so slightly touching the release of oxidizer in the main valves. I think they're gonna give it a shot here. It's clearly combusting a little bit, but it's at the temperature. Story of redundant mission system. And it's getting warmer in there, and enough to temperature with the temperature they want. Yeah, this is tough, guys. This is really tough. Our team is persistent, and as I can see, like many of you guys are too, in trying to get this REV-V engine lit. running out of fuel, running the oxidizer staying low. Where we might do a little tap on the main valve of the oxidizer just to drench it in oxidizer. And I'll be right there. So, yep. They are trying all options here. And we just, I think that really hesitant about pulling the last off if it doesn't work. And there's a small chance it would, that if it doesn't work, then that's it. We got to shut down the show. And we really don't want to. We really want to get this sucker lit. This is Red B with a MAREVL engine. It's all new parts and pieces. New injection system. New dimensions on the fuel core, the fuel grain, and new nozzle, new dimension of the nozzle, and the whole chamber is actually a little bit longer. Team's talking about that ace in the pocket option right now. Hybrids are hard to light, they're notoriously hard. when you make all these changes and you do this in cold, moist weather, man, it's hard. Thanks, Vatsiana. Yeah, it's just all about persistence and trying over and over and over again. We'll definitely work hard to diagnose what happened and ensure it doesn't happen with the next test. But this goes for a record for us in terms of persistence, the longest attempt for us to ignite this engine or any of our engines. There's a question about glow plugs. We actually don't use glow plugs. We use sort of custom-made spark plugs. The real MAREVL tonight is how many people are outside, freezing their buns off, and still out there, despite no ignition. That is the true MAREVL of the night. So really appreciate everybody who's held tight as we're waiting for this engine to light. Stratus 2X asks, are the main valves also stuck? Don't believe so. We have actually not hit the main valves yet. So right now it's just the ignition system. All right, we're going to go for the upper option very shortly here. And if this doesn't work, I think this will be a record. So we'll see. This is definitely something we've done before. and we'll see what goes down. But this is going to be a little more rambunctious than we've normally done with any test. We're going to go for it here in about 15 seconds. I'm going to try this one. If this doesn't work, this might be it for tonight. It's getting a little late for folks here. So here we go. Hey, that showed some. All right. I think we're seeing the nuclear option might have possibilities. Nuclear option's working here. How many pounds of thrust? How many pounds of thrust we should have is we're shooting around 16,000 to 17,000 pounds of thrust is what we're expecting. I am a little burp that we just saw. It was fire. I don't know how many pounds we pulled out of that. To start, we're having some concerns. We're thinking the spark is no longer working. The igniter is no longer igniting. It was that nuclear option we were talking about, that sort of ace in the back pocket. We knew if we couldn't pull it off, it might not allow us to relight. Try that again. Let's see. No. Alright. I'm going to say the game's probably going to be over here. That would have cooled down the engine a whole lot real fast. Yeah, I'm going to guess that it's going to be a couple days, so the team's going to debug and figure out what's going on. But I think we saw here is, the igniter has probably been toasted, and it's not going to relight. We won't see more sparks. So this is going to be it for the night, but I'm going to check in one more time with engineering. All right, you know, I'm already being shown wrong. We've seen this before. This thing that we've seen before where the spark fails, and we've got to wait a little longer and just let it get back to ambient conditions before we retry. Boy, this is a stunker beast, and it's a good reminder if you have a hybrid engine, have redundant igniters on board. Thank you. Okay, I don't know how many of you guys are still with us, but wow. So I literally was just out telling the folks waiting outside, I don't think it's going to happen. We're probably going to shut it down. And in that moment, I saw off in the distance, looking ahead of me, the engine lit, and they're lit. So the data looked really good. The burn from my view, and I actually haven't seen the video view. I haven't seen the view you guys just had, but the from my standpoint outside the RV here, that looked like a much cleaner burn, and it sounded much tighter. It didn't sound like a sloppy burn. But the important thing is, I heard from the engineers that not only did we do over 16 or 17,000 pounds of thrust, but we went beyond what I thought was full tilt for this engine. I thought we were only going to ever achieve 20,000 pounds of thrust, and my understanding is we hit about 21,000 pounds of thrust. This is fantastic news. This is really good news. So all the long wait, and I really want to thank everybody who was persistently waiting out there to see this engine burn, but thank you guys so much for being holding tight and all the funny jokes on the channel get to see. But this is fantastic news. Persistence pays off. And what we're seeing today is that the persistence and the ingenuity of our team is indeed paying off. And incredibly and wonderfully, we're seeing that all the design is having even better results than we were expecting. And this bodes very well that this will be sort of the final dimension and spin up of the MAREVL engine. I expect our new injector system will be what we use in Starless Rogue. It will be literally what you saw burn today. That injector system is going to be on Starless Rogue. So thank you guys all very much. This has been a little more dramatic than I was expecting, or certainly a little more drawn out than I was expecting. So thanks everybody. Thanks to the town of Brunswick, the folks here in the town who are probably still surprised that they might have heard that was a jet engine. And thanks to all the folks who came, we investors, potential investors, media, and the general public, the folks who are parked up along the road here, waiting very, very, very patiently for this engine.